Hi, everybody. Welcome to Game Dev Tycoon. Or should I say, welcome back to Game Dev Tycoon. I have played this before. It was years ago, though. The game's changed a little bit since. And it's one of these games over the years that I keep coming back to from time to time. Like, I just have, like, an itch that I need to scratch with Game Dev Tycoon. So here I am, once again, playing it and recording it. This is the second time I've recorded it. It's not the second time I've played through the game or whatever, because it's a surprisingly fun game. Anyway, we're going to make our own game development company today, and we're going to start working on some games. Cool. I guess we want to make a new game. We don't want to continue the legacy of Bifco games. We're going to make a new game. All right. Welcome to Game Dev Tycoon, blah, 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 blah. We all know about this. It sort of follows the whole evolution of gaming through from, you know, like the Atari and the early home PCs and the Commodore 64 and all that stuff. And then leads up into like the next gen consoles, like the Xbox One and big like MMO games that you can make and stuff like that. So we'll follow that through. And then I guess at the end of this, what we want to do, hopefully, is maybe make like a really cool MMO or something, or I don't know, reinvent Steam or something like that. Anyway, we're going to see. Great. Before we start our adventure, we have to give ourselves a company name and we have to pick a look for our dude. Do we want to be ginger? We probably don't really want to be ginger. Let's go for like an Asian look, shall we? Like, this guy may not actually be Asian, but to me, from behind, he looks a little bit Asian. So let's go for that. And let's put him in something real snazzy. Like that. That's nice, isn't it? It's like a dress shirt with like one of those like sweater vest things over top. I think that's pretty good. We need to think of a cool company name and a cool CEO name for our guy as well. What kind of company name could we go for? Like, should we just call it like something really cool? Like, you know when you used to play Doom and stuff and then you found out that it was ID Software and it's like, that's a kind of a weird name for like the company that's made this game called Doom. Like, you would have expected it to be like Hell Games with a Z or something like that instead. But like ID Software is just, it didn't really do it much justice. I mean, if we're going to be making some really high-end, amazing games and stuff, we want something that sounds kind of cool, right? Like Blizzard. Blizzard is a cool name for the company because like that spell is used in most of their games and stuff too. So like it kind of makes sense. I mean, I don't know what kind of stuff we're going to be really doing like games-wise. We're probably going to make like a lot of like dancing games and stuff like that. So should we call just... Let's just call ourselves like, I don't know, Hell Balls. Hell Balls. Vax. Biz. Hell balls. Yeah, with the Z. There we go. We can reinvent Doom, and we could be like Hell Balls Limited. Yeah, Hell Balls Limited. All right, and then we need a name for our CEO who is possibly Asian, but maybe not. Maybe might not be at all Asian. So should we give him something like a compromise in between Asian and not Asian? Let's just call him Brian. Let's just call him Brian Zakowski. No, you know what? Let's just like leave a bit of mystery to Brian and just simply call him Brian. All right, Brian of Hell Balls Limited. We are ready to create video games from the comfort of our own garage. I mean, there's a big coincidence here because I'm currently also sitting in my garage, which looks very similar to Brian's garage. Do we want to unlock hints? Let's not, actually. We'll create our own hints as we go because I haven't played in a couple of months and I can't really remember all of the stuff that works. I mean, I roughly remember some of it, but not all of it. So what we'll do is we'll disable the hints. We don't want to import all of our hints previously gained. And we'll start gaining some new ones for this playthrough. And I think that'll be fine. Okay, so we'll hit no. And we have, my God, look at this. We have like all of these Cipsco games, like the original one. I've used up all my save slots. Look, Barbecue Bob's Games, Shitsko, Ronson Games, I don't even remember that one, and Biffco Games, I did 6 months ago. Some of these like 2 years ago. Holy crap, that's crazy. All right, let's go for slot number two. We'll hang on to Sipsco Games just in case, right? All right, we want to overwrite Ronson Games. And do we want to review? No, okay, that's great. Okay, congratulations, you started your own game development company. At the moment, your office is in a garage. Don't knock it, it's fun having an office in a garage. Take it from me. And you are the only employee, but don't worry, many successful businesses have started out this way. Exactly. Let's start developing your first game. Close this message. Okay, great. I don't know why the tutorial's on. Anyway, we got an achievement. We supported a young startup by buying the game. I mean, we did buy the game. Excellent. All right, so what are we going to do? We are going to, I guess, develop our very first game. It's always very exciting. We don't really need the tutorial, so we can just skip all of this crap really quick. All right, our game concept. What's our first game? We called ourselves Hellballs Limited because we wanted to reinvent Doom, right? And we can't really use the name Doom. And I don't even know if the games industry is ready for Doom yet, because it's going to be text-based. There's going to be a lot of, like, ASCII. There's not going to be, like, any good graphics or anything like that. But I don't know. I mean, when Wolfenstein 3D came out, if you remember that a long time ago, this is the game that sort of, like, was the precursor to Doom. It was like sort of at a time where, you know, this very pixelated graphics, like 16-bit graphics, and, you know, there was like sounds and stuff, but if you didn't have a sound card, it would just play out of the back of your computer and make like those bleeps and bloop noises and stuff like that. So, like, I don't know, you could almost argue that maybe computers weren't ready for... Oh. Great. Anyway, I got another achievement for waffling. Anyway, we don't want to call it Doom. We want to call it, like, it's going to have space marines, okay? They're going to go to Mars, and they're going to fight aliens on Mars. So maybe we should just call it, like, Marines. Great. Marines on Mars. Okay. And this is somehow catchier than the name Doom, which is actually pretty catchy. Anyway, we'll call it Marines on Mars. All right. Of course, we don't have any topics unlocked, so we're going to have to change the sort of premise of the game slightly. So that instead of fighting aliens on Mars, we're instead going to fight either lawyers, schoolgirls, vampires, or zombies. It's quite a good selection. I'm going to go with vampires because it's the most realistic. Because we don't know, right? We haven't been to Mars yet. Like, you know, we've sent, like, some robots there and stuff. But they're not, like, they're not really dependable. You know, sometimes they report stuff back and it's like, there could be a colony of vampires on there for all we know. And maybe there is. All right. The type of game this is going to be is, of course, going to be an action game. A vampire action game could work, called Marines on Mars. I have no idea. And we have two platforms that we can pick from because it's early days. We have the PC with those big-ass floppy disks. And it looks like this one can take two of them, which is pretty high-end. And then we have the G64, which is, of course, the Commodore 64. If you ever had one of those and played Beachhead and, like, Spy Hunter and all those kind of games on it. Let's develop for the PC. Actually, you know what? The Commodore 64 is not going to be around for very long, and it's got a bigger market share. Let's develop for the Commodore 64. Why the hell not? Anyway, Marines on Mars, a vampire action game on the Commodore 64. Let's do it. It's going to be... Now, we can spend a bit of money here, and we can add some graphics. And actually, I think for a vampire action game, graphics would be good. It'd be much better than text-based. And it'll be a little bit like Wolfenstein 3D when it came out, where it's like, oh shit, will my computer run this? I might need a boot disk and stuff like that. Marines on Mars? Okay, fine. We're gonna do it. We spent 10... This is always like a bit of a tricky moment, right? Because sometimes you spend that 10 grand, you're like, shit, I really need that 10 grand. Like, I need to fix my DeLorean or whatever, and it's like, oh, shit. All right, so it's a vampire action game. I think we're going to go heavy on the gameplay. We don't really care about stories and quests at all. And the engine, we sort of care about, but not really. So we'll leave the engine at half. We'll go full throttle for gameplay. And stories and quests, we don't care about at all. We care less, right? And that's development stage one for Marines on Mars. Okay, perfect. Look at this. Brian is like all over it. He's already created two bugs. He's done more bug creation than he has done design and research. Almost combined as well. But his technology score is pretty good. Game development started. Excellent. We can do other stuff while we're doing the game development, but there's not much to do out here in this garage, so we're just going to wait. We're just going to let Brian produce his balls, his more bugs. Development stage 2, Marines on Mars, vampire action, no problem. We don't really care about dialogues, but we really want to have awesome level design, right? Like, if you ever watch the behind-the-scenes stuff on, like, Team Fortress 2 and everything when they're talking about designing the levels, that's kind of like an action game, right? So, like, we want the same. We want Marines on Mars to have really awesome levels. And none of that, like, nonsense where it's, like, an invisible wall and stuff like that. We're going to make sure it's all enclosed and nice and, like, it immerses you fully and stuff. It's going to be great. Artificial intelligence, I think we can just leave like that. And dialogues, like I said, we want them rock bottom. Like, our hero is not going to say anything. And the vampires don't talk. They're just bloodthirsty. They're basically like zombies. They don't talk or anything. They just have some sort of weird, like, telekinesis that they use to communicate with each other. But, you never hear it, so. Alright. Perfect. Basic sounds. Yeah. See, this is what I'm talking about. We want some good sounds. I think we want some good sounds, and I think we probably want some good graphics as well. We went for 2D graphics V1. World design, I don't think we care about at all. The world design does not need to happen. Let's go for good graphics over better sound. Because at this point in the game, I don't know, actually, Commodore 64, could you get like a sound card for a Commodore 64? I can't even remember. I know you could for a PC, but... Well, let's just assume that you have to buy a sound card, and let's assume that not everybody's going to have one, and some people will just be listening to the bleeping and blooping out of the back of their speaker or whatever. So let's not invest too much in sound, but we'll go, like, full hog on the graphics. And, like, Brian can just sit there and just, like, paint these beautiful pixel arts and stuff. He'll love it. He really likes doing all that. He doesn't want to get any paint on his, like, sweater vest thing with, like, the nice shirt underneath. Great, we're done. Marines on Mars is done, but we have to fix these bugs first. The nice thing about fixing the bugs, of course, is that occasionally you get extra design and technology points, like in between and stuff too. See, like we're getting some extra points. And then you have to time it perfectly so that you don't accidentally get a bug. There we go. Like that. There we go. We're done. We finished it. Perfect. All right, we're ready to go. We've gained a whole bunch of experience. We got a new topic and a new combo. So I guess like a vampire action, it works, possibly. Yeah, we got like a times 1.5 bonus, which is pretty good. All right, we'll just like skip all this stuff. I mean, we could trash Marines on Mars. And maybe we could trash it now. And then in 10 years time, when it becomes like this, like, you know, unknown sort of cult classic or whatever, we can re-release it. But then... It's a lot of hype over like 10 years, right? And everybody's going to expect something amazing and they're not going to be able to deal with the fact that it was just a crappy, first gen game or something called Marines on Mars. Maybe we're better to release it. All right, fine. We're going to do it. Good judgment. Create a game with a good topic genre combination. Fantastic. Oh, we're already off to a great start here. We're going to make some big monies. It's going to be fantastic. First reviews of our newly released game, Marines on Mars, came in. Perfect. Oh, look, I see some high up, quirky, but good. Well, I'll take that. Look, I mean, it is a little bit quirky, but good game. Well, that's pretty good. Look, this is going to be high. Very enjoyable. Who would have thought? Game Hero, I guess, like vampires and they like Mars. Man, for our very first game with like a completely random topic combo and everything, pretty good. Marines on Mars, like, this could be like our big IP, right? Like, this could be, we could have like Marines on Mars 4, Mars is gone, so then they can move to like Neptune or something. That'd be fucking sweet. All right, great. We're gonna publish the game and we're gonna watch the bazingas come in. You ready for this? Once the tutorial mess, there we go. Hellballs Limited, a newcomer in the game industry, has just released their first game, Marines on Mars. The game received favorable reviews. With such a good start, Hellballs Limited are sure to gain fans. Are we going to gain fans? Like, this is the worst company name ever. Hellballs with a Z. It's just crazy. All right, here we go. We're pushing units big time. Holy geez, 6.6K units. Look at that. In its first week on the market, we made it in the charts at number 20. Oh my god. Now that your game is on sale, you receive the income, blah, blah, blah. We know all this already. Marines on Mars is so successful that we now have 26 fans. Shit, that's crazy, man. We're gonna have like some high expectations to live up to. Marines on Mars has achieved a company sales record with over 10K units. So, I mean, it's not hard. This is the first game that we've made as a company. This is an important milestone in the history of Hellballs Limited. Oh, man. Look at this. It's ranked 24th on the charts. Maybe this is like back in time enough for HMV to still be around. And maybe it's the HMV charts. Wouldn't that be something? Holy shit. All right. So we're gaining fans all the time. We now have 72 fans. We have 140 grand in cash off the back of this, which is pretty good. And we have like these new options, right? We can research, we can create, we can probably create our own engine, which would be pretty good. We have a couple of research points. So let's research like maybe a new topic or something. I think that's probably all that we can afford. Custom game engine we have to save up for. Let's go for a new topic. Because like fantasy, right? We can make an RPG, that'd be pretty good. We could make like a spy thriller. We can make some music games for like the Game Boy and stuff. Those sell really well to kids. We could movies as a topic. I don't know if that's very good, but let's go for fantasy. Like fantasy is an easy one. Like we can make a lot of money off fantasy. All right, fine. Fantasy it is. We're going to start researching. Brian is going to start researching the topic fantasy. I mean, Brian himself sits around in his garage and fantasizes all the time, so he should have no problem just like creaming through this one really quickly. There, he has done too. There, yeah, we've got like some extra stuff in our arsenal now. Marines on Mars is now off the market. It sold 21,729 units, generating 152,131 big ones in sales. Man, what a start. We're doing good. Like, our monthly costs are high, though. I don't know what Brian is actually spending 8 grand a month on. Like, that's a lot. Recent market studies suggest that the Govador G64 is steadily outselling competitors in the PC sector. Consumers prefer the lower price, greater availability, and the flexible hardware configuration over other home computers. Alright, that may be so. But we know that, like, in a couple of years' time, this thing is going to be gone. Like completely. They won't sell anymore and they won't make games for it anymore. Experts say that this might spell the end of competing hardware manufacturers. Holy crap. Maybe that's why. Maybe the whole competing hardware manufacturer thing is why it went under. Who knows? All right, let's do another game. We're going to develop a new game. We can't do anything related to Marines on Mars straight away. The market is not ready, okay? The world is not prepared. You know, it's had its time, and now we have to, like, we have to research our own engine. We have to get some better features in there so that when the sequel does hit, it's much better than the first one, and people are, like, blown away. So we're going to have to, like, fill in. You know, like, game dev companies sort of like have, you know, like think of your favorite game development company and think of your favorite game that they made, and if they've been consistent in the last couple of years, maybe they've made like 4 or 5 like really awesome games that you really like. But if you look in their back catalog when they first started out, they would have worked on all sorts of weird shit that makes no sense, and that's because, you know, that's what game development companies do. They have to like find their niche, I guess. They have to like carve out their slice and then they work from that sort of thing. So that this is the phase that we're in now. We're trying different things and then we're gonna hope that something sticks, like Marines on Mars. Before we name the game, let's pick the top. Let's go for fantasy. We've got it, right? We're gonna make a fantasy RPG. Oh, this is gonna be incredible. And on this platform, I think we could probably go for the G64 again. I think it'll be fine. We have no genre matches here whatsoever. So we have to keep working away at this and then maybe transition to PC after and build up like our knowledge base on like what works and what doesn't. All right, so we have a fantasy RPG and we're gonna release it on the G64. We've got Marines on Mars, right? And that's like our space marines fighting an evil horde of vampires that live on Mars, but they're undetectable and they don't communicate except for like through their minds and stuff. And maybe that's why we haven't been able to detect them, because the robots are like, they have like these big satellites to listen to things that are happening on the planet. And it's of course like radio silence because these guys are like communicating with their minds or whatever. I mean, we could kind of like borrow from that concept. We could have something like, instead of Marines on Mars, we could have like knights on an island on Earth still, right? But like, you would never, because knights are on horses and stuff, right? And like, depending where the island is, the water might be really deep and the horses may not have been able to get there. Maybe it could just be knights on an island. It's a fantasy RPG, but it's about like a bunch of knights who just wake up one day on an island. They're like, how did we get onto this island? And then you have to, it could be like a mystery as well. You have to role play through a mystery and find out why the knights were on an island. And then it turned out that it's like some mana or some garbage like fantasy shit that got them onto the island. And then they're all like, hey, let's fucking, I don't know, kill our horses or something. They would celebrate somehow. Anyway, we're going to have 2D graphics V1 for this as well. It's going to be really good. And we're gonna have to like mess around with the sliders a bit differently this time, because for a fantasy RPG, we want to go heavy on the stories and the quests, right? We probably don't care much about the engine in this case, and gameplay is gonna come like secondary, right? So the kind of stories and quests I'm thinking of for Knights on an Island is like, what happens when you wake up? You're a knight. You wake up one morning and you're like, shit, I'm on an island. You've got like all of your battle armor and everything, and your horse is like fully like suited up. Your squire is there and like your whole like repertoire is there and everything. But you're just randomly on this island. So like your first quest is going to be, you know, it's going to be one small step. It's going to be like, you know, find out where you are or something like that. And then it's going to branch off into like this glorious huge chain of events. And it turns out that there's like an evil wizard that used some mana and that's how you got there. But like, you'll find out over the course of like 85 hours that that's how it happened. All right, Knights on an Island, fine. With heavy emphasis on the storytelling and not so much the engine and maybe the gameplay either. Perfect. All right, dialogues. We're going to want some nice dialogues. And actually, even at this early stage in the game, we're going to want to get some of the big guns in. We're going to want to get the guy who does Fry's voice in Futurama in to do some voice acting, because he's very good. I don't know if you know this, but the guy who did Fry in Futurama also did the voice of Ren in Ren and Stimpy. And like, though that's, they're like opposite ends of the spectrum, right? And like, they're really good. So we're going to get him in, okay? He's going to voice, not your knight, he's going to voice one of the other knights who like just accompanies you around on the island, tries to find out what's going on. AI, I don't think we need any of for a fantasy RPG. Level design will go halves. So we want to make sure that you can immerse yourself in the world. It doesn't look like a big piece of garbage, but at the same time, we want most of the immersion to come from you having a conversation with this other knight who you're on the island with. I mean, there'll be a couple. Let's say there's like five, and Fry from Futurama voices like the main one that you talk to a lot. And then it could turn out that later on he stabs you in the back or something and like steals your horse and, I don't know, like slits your wrist and just like crams a whole bunch of cigarette butts up there and you get sick and then you have to be rescued by like the wizard. He uses like some mana or something and cures you. That would be pretty cool. I think sound and graphic, I think we could probably say sound we don't really need. Graphics we kind of want, and world design we're going to go heavy on, okay? Because there's got to be like a lot of stuff. It's a fantasy RPG, right? So we have to get like lots of lore created, lots of backstory and everything. Dude, just like lots of helpful things to make sure that you're immersed, right? We want you to be like in your basement playing this game and feeling like you're a real life knight stranded on an island with a guy who's threatening to slit your wrists and put some cigarette butts in there, and then an evil wizard with some mana maybe will do something as well. And we want you to feel like you're there, okay? Like, I mean, we can't make like smells of an island come out of your computer for like the full immersion, and there's no VR of course yet either, but we're doing the best that we can considering like the time that were creating Knights on an Island. So, fine. All right, we're going to go world design, graphics, and sound. And a lot of this is a learning process too, right? And like one thing that's changed in the game since the last time I played it is that when you do things, you try certain combos and stuff, the game remembers it and presents it to you. So it can tell you sort of like what you need to be like looking at so that you can get better scores on games and stuff. It's pretty good. Industry news, according to rumors, the Japanese company Nintendo is planning to launch its very own. Yeah, so this is the original NES. And they're going to launch that with Dinky King, of course. Many industry experts doubt that home gaming consoles will take off, but we are eager to see what Nintendo will deliver. All right, perfect. Great. We have to iron out a couple of bugs in Knights on an Island, but we're nearly there. We're going to hit a new design milestone. And Brian, of course, just incurred $8,000 worth of costings this month somehow. I guess he just buys like all branded groceries or something. Like that's maybe why it's so... All right, we got a new topic and new combo. We knew that this combo was going to be a good one. Fantasy RPG is just like a staple of video games, isn't it? So like, that's going to be a good one. But we used our new topic that we researched, and Knights on an Island is ready to go. And it's been designed really well. Look, 16 design points. Oh, okay, let's see how we do. Brace yourselves. The first reviews are coming in for Knights on an Island. All right, look, we're going to get a 10 for sure. We got this. RPG games work well on the G64. This is according to Star Games. It's beautiful. Informed Gamer, thanks very much. Played it for days. Game Hero, well, it's designed. It's like takes hours. Love it. Holy shit. Knights on an Island, I think, is even better than Marines on... it's a bit of a theme here, isn't there? Like, maybe we can make, like, a car mechanic simulator later on and call it, like, Cars in a Garage or something like that. That would be good, too. All right, I'm happy with those scores. We're going to make a lot of money off Knights on an Island. It's going to be great. How many units are we going to ship in its first week? About as many as we did Marines on Mars, which is... interesting. We have 136 fans now. Today, Nintendo has confirmed recent rumors, and the NES, or well, in this game, the TES, is coming out. Did you know that they're re-releasing these? Nintendo have like made them with like a HDMI cable and stuff, and they're gonna re-release them with a bunch of games and stuff too. So now you can throw away all your emulators and ROMs that you've been playing for years and rebuy all of this stuff. It's gonna be really good, and crucially as well, you can play it like on your TV. Legit, it's gonna be fun. I can't wait to play some of those old games like Master Blaster. Or was it Blaster Master? There were some really fucking weird NES games, gotta be said. It was at a time when they were just like trying to make arcade games on home consoles, but then some companies were straying from it, realizing that they didn't need to be. Oh, thanks. This is from Patrick and Daniel Klug to say thanks for purchasing the game and not pirating it. No problem. I mean, I bought this way back when. It wasn't even on Steam when I bought this. It is now on Steam though. That's very good. This, what a nice note, isn't it? Oh, thank you very much. Okay, anyway, back to it. We're ranked 22nd with Knights on an Island. We've so far sold 26,000 units of this game, and we've pretty much doubled the cash that we had in the company, which is pretty good. Knights on an Island is now off the market. It sold 26,082 units, and it generated 182,602 big ones in sales. Man, fucking Hellbows Limited is off to a roaring start. We have 22 research points that we can spend. But we'll probably do that next time, and we'll be back next time to develop some more games, go through the history of gaming, and play this wonderful game once again, because it's a lot of fun, and I really enjoy it, and like I said at the start, we're going to make like an MMO or something and see how long we can go with that. Basically, we'll stop when we go bankrupt, so whether that happens before or after making an MMO, I have no idea. But that'll be the goal, and we'll see how close we can get to doing that. Excellent. Well, as usual, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next one, which should be out tomorrow, I guess. And I'll see you next time.